Hi, I'm Bill Griffith, an application engineer from Agilent Technologies. Today I'd like to talk about some tips and tricks for troubleshooting with your benchtop DMM. First, you'll want to start with a high quality set of probes. These are the 34133A probes. They're very small, so it's easy to probe on a very dense circuit board. In addition to that, they're very sharp, so if there's any dirt or oxidation on the PC board, they'll cut right through it. Lastly, they're spring-loaded, so that if you look away, they'll remain in contact with the PC board. Next, you'll want a DMM with a high-quality display. This is the 34411A. It uses a vacuum fluorescent display, so it's easy to read from a variety of angles and under multiple lighting conditions. The next feature is it has a dual display, which is useful because it's unusual to have a signal that's pure DC or pure AC. So in this case, I have a consumer power supply that isn't working properly. So we'll start by looking at the 12-volt supply. And as you can see on the display, it's reading 14 volts DC, so it's a bit high. On the second display, you can see the AC component, so it doesn't have a lot of noise on it, which is what you'd expect. We'll move on to the 5-volt supply. Once again, it's reading quite high. It's 6.2 volts approximately on the DC display. And again, it's not very noisy, as we'd expect. But as I go to the 3.3 volt supply, you can see it's reading a bit low, and it's kind of hard to make out that there's something else going on here. So what we're going to do is we're going to increase the integration time and try to make our DC volts a little bit more stable. So I'll go ahead and make that change. So I'm going to increase our integration time. So now we should see a more stable DC volt reading. I'm going to turn the second display back on. And now it's going to be measuring the peak-to-peak over that longer integration time, so we can see the true peak-to-peak value is over a volt. So it has quite a bit of AC noise on it, as well as reading low. So right away we can see the problem with this power supply. Let's move on to resistance. This DMM will auto-range very quickly, but if you know you're going to be probing the same resistance or similar resistance, you can also go ahead and put it into a manual range, and it'll just measure that much quicker. Another nice feature of this product is it has a trigger hold feature.